Hi, this is Michelle Martinez, and today we're starting the second study of Elijah and Elisha and the mantle being passed down to Elisha, and he is now the chief prophet of Israel. So we're going to go to 2 Kings 6, and this story is about the floating of the axe head of the prophet Elisha. And it starts by the sons of prophets who are still with Elisha goes to him and says, "Master, this area is too small for us. Our dwelling place has outgrown us." And he says, "If there's any way that we may be able to go to the Jordan so that we can each take part in having our own portion to build this new meeting place, where God will make room for us." And he says yes to the men. And the men go and they gather the tools that they need for the job that is going to be ahead. Now, when they get into the Jordan, one of the men who was cutting the tree down by the water swung and the axe head went in the water and sunk. And he cries out to Elijah because he knows that this axe head was not his, that he had borrowed it. And he says, "Master, my axe head has now sunk to the bottom and it is not mine. I have borrowed it." And Elisha says, "Where did it fall?" So he shows him where it fell. And it's the Bible says that Elisha grabs a stick and cuts it. And he throws it over where the man had pointed. And he used the miracle of God to bring up the axe head as it floated on the top of the Jordan. Then he said, "Now reach out your arm and grab your axe head." And the man did. So one thing that God showed me about this is that it does not say that the man had hesitated. It did not say anything but that the man did. So what if he would have hesitated? What if he would have took an extra second not to want to reach his hand out? Would it have sunken? We don't know. But one other thing that God was showing me about the story, because I was asking him, like, what else is in this story? Because I feel like there's some digging that needed to be done. Like, I needed to dive deeper into this particular story. And he brought me to 2 Kings 2, where we had started this study with how Elijah first worked with the water and showed Elisha how to move water. And so the Lord was showing me that in the moving of the water, that the Lord was putting placement and setting an order by this miracle. Because if you remember from part one of the study, it said that when Elisha and Elijah went into the Jordan, that the 50 sons of prophets stood up at the hill and they looked down from afar to be witness unto this miracle of the parting of water. So the more that I was looking and researching it, I also seen that the Lord was using Elisha at the time to do that miracle in front of these other sons of prophets. They would have not have all been the same men. So when he brought the axe head to the surface, that was a witness unto many, not only the man who have lost it, but the other men who were there in the building, and also for the man who he had borrowed the axe head from. So we don't know how far that story went in their community, but God was using this to set the order in place that yes, yes, Elisha is now this chief prophet of Israel, that he does now carry the mantle of Elijah for sure. So in this study, it really shows that the little things, they start to mean everything. So this, the grabbing out to the water, just that faith that it would take to do things like to grab that stick and to cut that branch off and to throw it in the water and to know that the Lord would bring that up. And when we were doing this book study through our leadership, the Lord showed me that we are to be more of the person who would cut the stick and throw the stick out upon the water, rather than the person always wanting to receive or always wanting their things to be brought up to the surface. Because it is a time now where people need, and we are people of miracles. If you are watching this video, it is an appointed time for you to hear this, that you are a miracle, that you can do the things that God is showing you that you can do, that it is your season to take your mantle that you have placed on you. And though you don't see it in the physical realm, it's there in the spiritual realm, and it is placed upon you. And some of us are running with mantles that have already been passed down from great men and women of God. And the Lord says it's time to choose your stick, to make your cut sure, to throw the stick out on the water, knowing that I will bring the axe head up for you to make changes in the lives of the people that are witnessing around you. What a great story that this was, with just all of the miracles of the water. I did do a little bit of research into the story of how Elisha takes the salt and he purifies the water with salt. Now, I'm a big fan of salt. I use salt a lot through my business with Worthy as the Lamb. And I loved going to the Dead Sea. It was a place of miracle, of rejuvenation. It's such a dead water. There's no living things in it because the salt there is 10 times saltier than any other body of water that you would see, like in any other ocean or anywhere in the world. And it is the lowest part of the earth. So it was really fun to find different kinds of soaps and salts there, especially like the sulfur soaps and stuff like that, because all of those things, they're so dead, bring so much life to your skin. So just a little thing that I like to share about, because it's something that I'm very excited about. I love working with the minerals that God has in Israel. I just think they're a blessing. Some people there think that that land is so cursed because it's so full of salt. But even though nothing can live in it, the fact that it brings life, it's such a miracle. Because the Bible says that things must die so that new things must live. So we have to take off our old skin, just like with the salt. It exfoliates, it rejuvenates, it puts that bounce back into your skin, but it's taking off layers for the newness. So as we remember in the story from part one, that it said that as Elisha took off his own clothes after Elijah had went off into the heavens, that he had ripped that his clothes in two and he had placed on the new mantle. So that's like a shedding of the skin for this newness and this new anointing that's coming. So we just want to say, dive deep into the things of God. Be excited about what God has for you. Don't think that stories just fall into your lap for no reason. Dive deep in this season. And we hope to see you guys next time.